full celebrity stories. This time, usually when I browse through the Inquirer, I do that. I just browse through. But for some reason, I'm in the mood for reading. Lisa Marie Presley. Here's the gum I'm chewing, by the way. This is the Bazooka original bubble gum. Druggie. Lisa Marie reunites with daughters. In a last-ditch bid to save her drug-addled daughter from an early grave, Priscilla Presley arranged an emotional family reunion, and the National Enquirer was there to capture the touching scene. Daughter Lisa Marie, age 49, had a tearful get-together with her twin daughters, Harper and Finley, age 8. Outside of her mother's Los Angeles area home on Memorial Day. Also on hand was her eldest daughter, actress model Riley Keough, celebrating her 28th birthday. The world exclusive photos snapped by the Inquirer show the first time all three of Lisa Marie's girls have been pictured together. Priscilla is hoping against hope that this heartfelt gathering will knock some sense into Lisa Marie, confided a family insider. Lisa Marie was very moved and wiped away a tear from her eyes, which were hidden behind mirrored glasses. She also wore a long flowing caftan to cover her emaciated frame. The reunion came just days after Lisa Marie reportedly attended the May 26th funeral of grunge rocker Chris Cornell, who committed suicide May 18th after a Soundgarden concert in Detroit. Attending the two events just days apart hit Lisa Marie like a 1-2 punch. Spilled the source. If they weren't wake-up calls, I don't know what would be. Oh. As the Inquirer reported recently, Elvis's only daughter has been at death's door after repeated overdoses damaged her internal organs, and her erratic behavior has pushed her own mother to turn her back on her. What's more is, as her brutal divorce war with fourth husband Michael Lockwood rages, Lisa Marie had rarely seen her precious twin daughters until now. Lisa Marie's behavior is out of control, the source spilled to the Inquirer. She's bouncing around between the homes of her adult children, Riley and her brother. Ben, because nobody can stand to live with her. Even her mother, Priscilla Presley, has grown tired of having to babysit her and has sided with Michael in the custody battle for their twins. Priscilla had made it abundantly clear that she doesn't want Lisa around the twins unless she's clean and sober. Tragically, despite the creature comforts provided by her famous father's $700 million fortune, Lisa Marie can't beat her demon, said the source. Lisa Marie is paranoid, and she's gotten herself into such a deep pool of manipulation and addiction that she doesn't even know how to get out. The Vulture, the insider. Her paranoia is reportedly ramped up to the point where she's hired investigators and used bugging gear to spy on Michael, according to sources. In addition to the drugs and despair, Lisa Marie says she's also suffering from ulcers and anemia. Tattled, an insider, she also has a bad back and esophageal issues. The source said Priscilla is praying that the reunion with her girls will help spur Lisa Marie to finally straightening out before it's too late. That's interesting. I wonder why did Priscilla choose to allow National Enquirer? That's kind of interesting. Let's say Sean Connery. Sean has seen better days. Sean Connery was once the dashing and charming star of 007 films, Super Spy James Bond, but these days he looks like he's waiting for Indiana Jones to pass him the Holy Grail. The gonk 86-year-old Academy Award winner was spotted shambling down a New York City sidewalk, unshaven, disheveled, after leaving a barbershop. What? That's terrible. Sometimes we just want to have a do-nothing day. He probably does that so he won't be recognized, so he can walk down the street. Oh my goodness. Angelina's brood grows without bread. Angelina Jolie is spotted with new kids while her ex begs for a second chance. What new kids? 1, 2, 3, 4. That looks like a mom. Hold on here. Mega mom Angelina Jolie out in LA with more than the usual number of youngsters. Some of those may be friends of her children. Well, yeah. Are they trying to make a story out of it? Kid crazy Angelina Jolie has given Brad Pitt the ultimate brush off, expanding her brood without him. Even as a remorseful actor begs for forgiveness, the National Enquirer can exclusively reveal that Angie was spotted with 4 of their children and a slew of new kids, several unidentified children of Asian descent join Angelina Jolie and her brood for a May 25th outing to the La Brea Tar Pit, prompting insiders to speculate that she plans to grow her family without Brad. And she's moving on with her life, and she's encouraging the kids to do the same, said an insider. Despite that, Brad's focused on winning her back, and he's relying on the lessons of Alcoholics Anonymous to help him get back on his feet. Brad is convinced that going back to Angie would be a different game now because he realizes the mistakes that he made, and he's so very sorry. Snitch to source. He believes that if Angie gives him a second chance, he'd be the happiest guy on the earth. And he's working through AA's 12 steps, writing letters to the people that have been hurt by his alcoholism, out of control behavior. But insiders believe the Fury Star, age 53, has his work more than cut out for him. Angie has heard the apologies before, and she's kind of over them, the source said. It's the kids that Brad really has to make an effort to make amends with. In fact, the Inquirer has learned that Brad also wrote to 15-year-old adopted son Maddox, who was reportedly abused by a boozed-up Brad during a private plane flight in September. The alleged incident pushed Angie to shock Brad with divorce papers. Brad's written letters to Maddox apologizing for his actions and for letting him down as a father. He feels terrible about how he treated Maddox on that plane, and Brad knows he has to earn back his trust. And it's not just Angie and the kids getting written apologies from the Fight Club star. The Inquirer has learned Brad has also contacted ex-wife Jennifer Aniston, age 48. Jennifer was another person he reached out to, and they're in touch, and they text, and Brad said he was sorry for whatever pain he put her through. Just the fact that he's saying that he's sorry means a lot to Jen, and they have found peace. Even though their marriage didn't work out, there's still a lot of love there and mutual respect between the two. There have been several other people that Brad feels he's injured along the way who also received a letter from him. Just last week, Inquirer reported that the alarmingly gaunt star was rocked by the deaths of two close pals, producer Brad Gray and Soundgarden rocker Chris Cornell, leading some to speculate that his fragile sobriety could be shattered. The two deaths hit Pitt like a 1-2 punch, source confided. It could push him back over the edge. So, she's not expanding her brood. They've got to just be friends of her kids. Now it looks like a mom. Well, the article was more about Brad and his notes. Remember Matthew Perry from Friends? He's flat and sloppy now. Slurring out of its star of Friends is fearing disaster. Oh my God. What's going to happen to him? Bloated, bleary-eyed Matthew Perry has pals worried that he's fallen off the wagon yet again. The former Friends star, age 47, has had two stints in rehab now, and he slurred his words and looked punchy recently, even though he's hired a sobriety coach. Sobriety coach. Matthew is committed to staying clean, but he's finding it tough, an insider divulged to National Enquirer. He's taking it one day at a time. Well, there are a few. There are good days and bad days, and days where he finds the whole process a nightmare. On a recent episode of TV's Watch What Happens Live, Matthew sat stone-faced as he struggled through a painful chat with host Andy Cohen. Even more disturbing and out of it, Matthew stumbled over his words and seemed to lose his train of thought on Live with Kelly Ripa and Ryan Seacrest. Matthew's slurred speech on TV had friends worried about a possible slip, the insider said. It was even more concerning to see him looking disoriented in another interview. He was definitely not as lucid and upbeat as he's come across most of the time recently. Matthew's first addiction battle came in the mid-90s when he got hooked on prescription pills after a jet ski accident. The actor who played lovable Chandler Bing on Friends once admitted that he couldn't even remember 3 years of filming the show because of his addictions to booze and pills. 1997, he completed a 28-day program for Vicodin addiction. He entered a rehab facility again in 2001 for abuse of Vicodin, methadone, amphetamines, and alcohol. Now, he's committed to staying straight, his friends say. Matthew's hired a sober coach to help him make smart choices, an insider remarked. He's way healthier than he was boozing and blacking out. But it's a long-term project, and everyone's praying that he'll get through. A good one. Paula Abdul evicted from her house. She's been tossed out from her posh penthouse while she was on tour. Tom, another exclusive Enquirer exclusive. Tragedy at her doorstep. Remember, she had a mansion in Sherman Oaks, and there was this girl named Paula Goodspeed who overdosed near her home. That was 2008. I remember that. The singer was booted from this, from the penthouse in the Los Angeles building. A former American Idol judge. And there she is right there, and there's her chihuahua. Former American Idol judge Paula Abdul has been straight up evicted from her posh Los Angeles penthouse. Straight up, that's funny. Sources exclusively told the National Enquirer that Ditzy Paula, age 55, was bounced from her rented pad on the 19th floor by her landlords. What's more is the Forever Your Girl singer lost her home while on tour for the first time in 25 years, performing her greatest hits with New Kids on the Block and Boyz II Men. Paula's had more than her fair share of trouble with the places that she has lived in over the years. This is just the latest, spilled a source close to the singer. Paula was filming her reality TV program Hey Paula in 2007 when a woman named Jill Cole slipped and busted her back on the steep driveway of Paula's home in Sherman Oaks, California. And Jill sued the singer 2 years later and eventually settled for almost a million dollars. And then also, 2008, mentally unhinged former Idol contestant Paula Goodspeed was found dead of an intentional drug overdose in the car parked just a few doors away from Paula Abdul's mansion. Paula, a famed choreographer who has worked with Janet Jackson, George Michael, and Dolly Parton, finally unloaded the cursed home almost 4 years later for $1.8 million. According to her reps, she has already lined up a new pad, but one place where she apparently won't be finding a new home is in the American Idol reboot. Paula served as a lovable but loopy judge on the reality competition show, along with Simon Cowell, Randy Jackson, and for the first 8 seasons during the original run of Fox. The series ended in 2016, and ABC recently announced it's reviving the show. So far, only pop star Katy Perry has been confirmed as a judge, and Paula insisted that she doesn't want to come back. "I'm excited for the reboot," she said when asked about the program recently. "I had an incredible time on that show and blessed to be part of it from the beginning, but I think they need to do a whole reboot." Paula, who's worth an estimated $30 million, also called Idol one of her most life-changing experiences. She said, "I'm so beyond proud to have been there since the inception of it. I think ABC is a great home for Idol. I'm forever a fan." Aww. A-Rod cheated on J-Lo with me, a world exclusive. I did not know that A-Rod and J-Lo were like a serious couple, but I guess they are. So apparently, here's a woman he had sex with. National Enquirer exclusive. Stray Rod is the ultimate love rat as his wild nights of sex plunge Lopez into despair again. Well, I guess. I didn't know that. I do like Jennifer Lopez. We've been watching Shades of Blue, that TV show. And we started watching World of Dance, but Not as fun to watch that as Dancing with the Stars. Okay, so here we have Hollywood's hottest romance is over. Alex Rodriguez cheated on J-Lo with a glamorous fitness model through sordid phone sex, the hotel hookup arrangements, and even demands for steroids. In a blockbuster National Enquirer world exclusive tell-all, A-Rod's mistress, Lauren Hunter, exposed her raunchy romps with the disgraced New York Yankees swinger. Wild nights of rough sex, dirty talk, and twisted pleas for masturbation video. Oh my goodness. Lauren, age 35, revealed that the slugger, once suspended from America's Pastime in a steroid scandal, dogged her relentlessly, made her dress as a schoolgirl, and pleaded for a secret rendezvous in Kansas City, May 17th, and he was in town watching his former team play the Royals. All while clueless, J-Lo was on the set filming Shades of Blue in Queens, New York. What's more is Strayron even trashed J-Lo as a 40-something woman to Lauren, who'd been his sex toy for more than 5 years, sticking his tongue out and laughing when she pressed if their relationship was real. Jennifer is going to be shocked, Lauren boasted to the Enquirer in a 5-star hotel suite in St. Louis, Missouri. She would be an idiot to believe that he'd be faithful. That's terrible. So I thought she has all these text things and pictures and video. I even said over FaceTime, you know, this whole Jennifer stuff, I just don't believe this. And he just stuck his tongue out when he made the face that made me think it was fake. Lauren learned about A-Rod's relationship with J-Lo by reading it in the Enquirer. When she quizzed the ex-jock about it, he shrugged it off, saying he'd kept her in the dark. Oops. Because I don't want to tell you stuff like that. Lauren and A-Rod first met at Equinox Gym in West Hollywood. In West Hollywood, 2011, while he was romancing Cameron Diaz. And they hooked up shortly afterward. I slept with him, and then he went to the MTV Awards with Cameron Diaz, Lauren said. She looked really sad. I could see it was the end. Lauren and Alex continued to meet in hotel rooms for 12-hour sex marathons. She said, he told me he loved me and he's loved me for a long time. Even the first time that I was with him, he said, I love you and we should be married. We could be a power couple. What do you think people would think of us, how we'd look together? He's very into his image. The single mom who has 2 children from a prior relationship and 1 with NFL Hall of Famer Marcus Allen revealed A-Rod offered her a $20,000 allowance to have a threesome with a longtime partner. He likes muscular women, she said. Even when he was with her, he would say, I'll pay you $20,000 a month. And he wanted us to be 2 girlfriends. But Lauren said, you can't buy me. Even though she once thought she wanted a form of commitment with him, and needed a piece of paper from A-Rod. In a twist, Lauren and J-Lo once crossed paths at the Beverly Hilton restaurant. The singer and actress actually interrupted Lauren's dinner with a former NBA franchise owner, the sex pot revealed. She's a dog-eat-dog girl, and she's got to where she's being that way, Lauren added. She's not stupid. It takes a true witch. I mean that in a good way. I wish I had that energy to do that. But Lauren is gutsy and candid too. She spilled all about her times with A-Rod since he began dating J-Lo earlier this year. All the months up until they start seeing each other. Maybe February or March, and he was always inviting me places, she told the Enquirer. It was like, if we're not going to be in a relationship, leave me alone, because you don't get anything out of me. You're not getting sex. A week before his relationship with J-Lo was announced, he was asking me to go to Miami. When I found out, I texted him and said, I found out. when they went to the Bahamas, and he never even mentioned her. I was like, this has to be fake. Then he started sending me ellipses and texts. It looked like somebody accidentally did it, but he was fishing. He just can't say, hey, how are you? Because I didn't know him. I think curiosity killed the cat, and it was bugging him. Then he started sending all this nice stuff. Again, about a week later, in the beginning of April, they were already back from their trip, and he was in Miami, and she was somewhere else. Then he started video calling me 3 or 4 times a day. I miss you, Lauren. You want to FaceTime me later? And then, are you home alone? And Lauren replied, is that where you wanted me? In my bed. A-Rod is texting all this hot stuff. And then Lauren tells A-Rod, one more thing. Since I've relinquished the idea of us ever being in love and together, next time you do a publicity stunt like this, at least tell me rather than letting me see it on Google or in a grocery store. So he apologized and says, I'm sorry, and it won't happen again. A-Rod pleaded, let's be loving and nice to each other. See you on Wednesday. And she says, I've been thinking about it. And then he wants her to drive to Kansas City and see her. On and on. So she reveals all these steamy hot texts. So long story short, she didn't make one of several trips that A-Rod wanted. She told the Enquirer that she couldn't arrange child care for her 3 children, even when I FaceTimed him. I was thinking, what's going on? He told me he tries not to be on his phone when he's with Jennifer, but says you can still text me. I'm like, what are you worried about? I'm not even jealous. We have our own situations. And A-Rod was asking me who I slept with. Everything about A-Rod is passionate, loving, and sweet. He'll kiss and cuddle you. But sex is not soft and gentle. He's rough with sex. He's good in bed, on and on. But he loves threesomes. He always wants me to talk about sexual moments. This isn't the first time that A-Rod has been caught with his pants down. He was thrown out of his own home by his wife, Cynthia, in 2008, over a tryst with Madonna. And then he was caught with an exotic dancer. So, he asked me to arrange a shipment of steroids before flying out to visit him. Lauren told friends that A-Rod asked for testosterone and a few other things. 2009, A-Rod admitted to using steroids. From 2001 to 2003, when playing for the Texas Rangers, due to an enormous amount of pressure to perform after signing a $252 million deal. Now, Lauren has a dire warning for jail. I would never marry him. Yeah, J-Lo, she's been with, like, a lot of guys. Remember Ben Affleck? Well, before Ben Affleck, she was with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 guys. But Ben Affleck, Mark Antony, then a couple guys, even Bradley Cooper, And then the guy from Dancing with the Stars, Max Tchaikovsky, Drake, A-Rod. That's crazy. That's a lot of guys. Oh my goodness. Christine Taylor had enough of Ben's jealousy. Jealousy behind control. Insecure shrimp, Ben Stiller is getting divorced from his wife of 17 years, Christine Taylor. And the National Enquirer has learned it was a paranoia that drove her to throw in the towel on their marriage. Ben's extremely paranoid and often told his friends that he felt like he was out of his league with Christine, said a close snitch to the 51-year-old Zoolander star. His worst nightmare was that she'd leave him one day for a taller, hotter man. What's more is that same source squealed that whenever Christine was out of town on a job, which wasn't very often, Ben would eventually recruit someone on the set to spy on her. The couple have two children, and Christine grew tired of Ben's drama and accusations, especially when he'd have two stunning blonde chefs on his own movie sets out of the source. But Ben tried to control everything she did, even micromanage her diet. Oh my